Welcome, fans of World of Tanks. Glad you could join Penny Packer in this replay of the German Tier 7 Heavy, Tiger 1. This is a very capable heavy featured in the German tech tree. I highly recommend it, and it will be noted that one game after this, I did receive my first mark of excellence on this particular tank. Awfully proud of that. Always an accomplishment, a sense of pride, and somewhat of a badge of honor. Having said that, let's move on to basically just explain that we're one of a few Tier 7s in this match. It went well, and we were able to kind of showcase what the Tiger 1 is capable of. And I will say that at Tier 8 and even 9, the Tiger 1, if played correctly and in position, can basically contribute all around. So if you have not, I will highly recommend this particular tank to be experienced if you are a faithful and enthusiastic World of Tank player. Therefore, having said that, let's enjoy this match as it is unfolding. And I'll make some few comments as we move along. As you can see here, we sit back here with the Tiger P and basically are using our angled armor here to ricochet what we can and take some shots as we see enemies exposed under the archway of that bridge ahead of us. That is a common choke point on this map, and we do see quite a few fruitful targets ahead of us during this match, and we cherry pick them quite often. Not to be said though that we do take some shots of our own, and don't stay here the whole match. We do end up moving around, and we do make a push a little bit later. But this is a good starting point nonetheless, and we had a lot of success here. So if you find yourself on this side of the map when you're starting off, I personally, and this is just me personally, my own opinion, like to go to this side and try to work on this area. Angle correctly, this tank can and will ricochet most Tier 7 and 6 cannons and shells. So that is one of the more effective ways of using it right here. As you move up against higher tier opponents, some flanking strategies may be employed to basically prolong the lifespan within the match. Sniping is always an option as well. Has a very accurate gun, low aim time, decent shell velocity, good penetration for a Tier 7, and the premium rounds are pretty deadly as well. As you can see, the reds basically stayed on the other side of that crest in the middle of the map, did not really push that much. We were able to be very patient back here, and as the reds did move around and become a little bit more impatient in their own area there, they exposed themselves quite regularly. Some shots did not find their mark, but nonetheless, we kept the cannon hot. As the match moved along, it remained relatively even throughout. This was not a slam dunk on anyone's part. Red or green could have gone either way. As you can see, trading tank for tank here. And in this instance, could I have pushed and been a little more aggressive perhaps, but not everyone's strategy is, let's just say hindsight's 20/20. So. Without knowing what would happen, basically held my position back here until I felt it was safe enough to push.
Enemies looking right at us.
And as you can see, my Tiger P friend left a little while ago. I don't know the whereabouts of him or even if he was still around. And here we move along, starting our push. Still had a pretty even match here. In fact, we're down one tank, so throwing all caution to the wind, we enter the red domain here. Quickly fire upon a tank destroyer nestled by the building over there. And my first thought here was, well, let's just go and cap. We're over here. No one's going to come back. And having watched my teammates' antics here, I realized I don't think they want to cap. So, a quick change of heart, and I head back towards the position of the Reds. And here we go. As soon as we crest this hill, you will see that we have a pretty good amount of Reds to shoot at over here. Targets are all just basically lined up, like target practice. And here we go. We're on top of the hill. As long as we make these shots count, we should be fine. I will say that I really enjoy this tank. I do have the Tiger 131 and the Hammer varieties of this particular tank. Neither one of those would disappoint you. In fact, the Tiger 131 has a magnificent reload of somewhat over 5 seconds. The quickest of the Tiger variants. There's also a new one in the store right now. If you act fast, you can get it before Tuesday. It is a Russian variant of the Tiger 1. They did mount a 100mm cannon on it, though, from the Russian arsenal. I believe that came off a medium. Tiger tanks are very famous. We're having fought many battles during World War II. Very capable tank. In fact, in many ways, the Tiger tank itself is what basically showed how capable a tank could be on the battlefield. An execution of fine craftsmanship. And here we pull down a first class. Not a bad match at all, pretty solid. Plenty of damage, and as one of the top tier tanks in the room, we did manage to stay at the top of the list here and contribute quite nicely. So no disappointments here in this match at all. Ladies and gentlemen, the Tiger 1, World of Tanks. Thank you.